So moving on, so as I have told you, we have two things over here. One is outgoing, one is incoming server. Okay, incoming mail server. So for outgoing, we have the send email. So using that outgoing server, we can send email. Now incoming. So how to handle all the incoming mails? Okay, so we have a command called email automation. So using email automation, we can handle all the incoming mails. Okay. So let's see one by one. There are three subcommands including email automation. One is get all messages, delete all messages, and delete a specific message. Okay. So first is get all messages. So this is how it looks like. You can see get all messages leaves messages on the server. So here, email server details. Here you need to provide your incoming mail details. So let's say mail dot. Here you need to provide IMAP. We have a server type IMAP and POP. If you're selecting IMAP, so you can provide IMAP. You can provide the host name as imap.mail.yahoo.com. If you want to use Yahoo Gmail, you can get the server configuration from web itself directly searching internet because it is globally available. So just type in Yahoo Outlook server details or Gmail Outlook or Hotmail, Rediff, Yahoo, whatever you have, and provide the host name over here. Provide your username. Provide your password. Okay. And one more thing, you can see we have this thing called tip here, here, and here. So you can also, you know, save this detail in a variable, okay, and use it. Okay, F22 insert a variable, F22 insert a variable. So here you can get the information. You can use a variable also, insert a variable, and you can provide the details, save it in a variable. So basically, you can use a variableized code over here. So as of now, this is a fixed text which I am putting it over here. If you want, you can get the values from variable also. Okay, and same here. If your incoming mail has a server authentication or secure connection or not. Okay. So if it uses SSL connection, you can make this checkbox checks. Then the server type. If you're using IMAP, you need to provide accordingly your port number. So this right now it's a default one. Okay, use default. If you want, you can update it as per your requirement. Okay, so say I'm using 993, this is a default one. You can modify as per your IMAP port address. Same here, F2, you can insert a variable. And then we have three types, all, read, and unread. Suppose say you want to perform action with only read messages. The messages which are in your inbox, which are read, you need to perform action only with those messages. You if you don't want to touch all other messages or unread messages, only the red messages you want to operate with, then you need to check the reds read. And same way, if you want to operate only with unread messages, leave the red messages behind. Like only want to operate with the red unread messages, you can need to select the unread option. Okay. Message format HTML or plain text. Suppose say HTML selection. Okay. And then the save attachment. If you want to save the attachment which is there in the email messages, okay, so right now I've selected unread, so it will only operate with the unread messages. And if any attachment found in the unread messages, then you can provide the path over here. Let's provide a path, select a folder. It will always take folder, okay, you can't save it in a file attachment. Always provide a folder attachment. That's the example over here. Same way, if you want, you can insert a variable. You can save the path, location, path in a variable, and insert this variable. Okay. So this is how it looks like in order to get all the messages. Same way, if you want to get all the messages, you need to select this all messages. So if you select all, so it will, you know, loop all the messages. Okay. So now see, I have inputted all the details over here, and now when I click on save, your code will look like this. Okay, it will take a loop. It will take. Let me show you loop. So when I expand this loop, we can see this thing over here. For each email message on a mail server, let's drag and drop this. Okay, see, for each email message on a mail server, same thing you got, which I have just now inserted from that email automation, get all messages. Same wizard you will see, get all messages, delete message, and delete a message. Okay, single message if you want to delete, use this. Delete all the messages, then you can use this. At one go, it will delete all the messages and get all messages. But here you are just looping when in the loop condition only this is highlighted. Okay, this is disabled. You can see this is disabled, only this is highlighted. Okay. So let's ignore this as of now because we are in this email automation command. Just wanted to show you that, you know, both the things looks like. You can directly insert get all messages, so it will come in loop format. But if you want to directly insert a loop, you can also use this each email messages. Both the code, when we save it, it will take the same format. Okay, it will get in the loop only. Okay, the command will get converted in the loop only. Why loop? Any idea why loop? Why, like, you know, see, suppose all other command, suppose like comment or clipboard, a simple command is one, but why? When we are selecting this get all messages, the code got converted in the loop format. Any idea? You can think of any like thing that why it got converted in loop. Why not a single get all messages command got saved over here? Any raw idea, rough idea?
Every time when a new message is received, the loop will execute.
Yes, more or less it's same. But a loop, because see, I hope you know the basic idea what loop does.
Yes, Anita. So it iterates the condition again and again till it meets the final condition.
Right. Okay. So this is how your simple, this is our a structure, I can say, a body, how a loop looks like. A loop keyword, then if check the condition, if it's true, then this particular statement which is stored in this loop will get executed. What it will do is, it will loop all the messages which is present in your inbox, okay? So that is why the code got converted in the loop format. Because it needs to loop all the messages, okay? At only one, if we have only one messages, even if one message, so it will loop all the messages, okay? The statement needs to be reiterated again and again until all the messages in your email inboxes work as per the action which we provide over here, okay? So hence this command got covered in the loop format. Then save it. Now what you want to do in this loop, suppose say I want to read a specific email message body or email subject, then we need to use this message box like standard we use. And in order to work with email messages, we have all these variables, okay? Email CC, email from, email message, email receive date, email receive time, and email receive subject. Okay, email to, and yeah, email to. Okay, so from email CC to email to, all these variables which we can use if we are working with the email automation command. Okay, let's say I want to read the email message. Click on insert. I want to read the email subject. Okay. You can, if you want, you can insert multiple variables which you want to. So as of now, I'm just like these two commands. These are the system commands when you're working with the email automation, and click on save. So what it will do is, when this will run, when the server will get connected to this particular outgoing mail server, sorry, incoming mail server from your inbox, it will check whether if you have provided correct username and password, only then it will get connected. And it will check the server type, and it will check the message format in the HTML format only. If this condition is satisfied, then it will enter in this loop. wherein you can, so right now it will loop in and show the message box. Okay, it will just display the message. So suppose say you have 50 messages, so 50 times this will iterate and it will show me the email message and email subject. So one more help which automation anyway has provided. Whenever you are like just dragging and dropping any particular command, you can see the comment over here. So this really becomes helpful. You can see when we use this command over here, this automatically populated. Okay, comment. Please enter your commands into this loop. Use email automation variable for each email on the server. Example, email from email to. So if you have any issues, if you want to see the system variable at any given point of time, click on this show system variable, click on this email, and you can see these are variables under email. You can make use of it too in your task, okay? And along with the description, see, it is used in loop only for each email in a server, okay? For each email in a server, this will return the email address, this will return you the email CCC subject content, email received, date and time, okay? So once I execute, so it will check this condition. If it meets, then this particular line will get executed. Okay. Any doubts in this email automation? Get all messages.
Vinita, I have a question to ask.
Yes.
Suppose I need to fetch a specific email which is having an attachment. Like we are running a bot on server. And some sort of email is we have received an email that bot is not running successfully, or some sort of I can say that attachment is there. So I need to fetch that specific email which is having attachment with a specific subject, and based on that I need to fetch that details, and whatever the data is over there, like I can say that it is having a set of username and password. So is it possible that I can fetch that specific means attachment, and that attachment is used something over there in another application, so that those username and password can be used over there as well?
Yes, definitely you can do this using automation anyway. So at that time, what you can do is, firstly, in order to read the email messages, because you need to identify, okay, you need to find the email, right, which has the email subject. So use this loop, use this get all messages. So once your code enter in the start loop, you can put a condition over here. So put a condition if, and you set that a specific email. So you can do one thing, create a variable. Let's say I am putting a subject, the subject. We have an email subject, okay. So this is the V subject, and here I'm putting, let's say I want to search all the messages which has server as a subject, save it. So I have taken a variable and I've inserted a value called text. So once I enter in this loop, I put a condition.
Can we use a while character over there in months means in the variable?
While characters.
Yes.
Wild characters you can insert, but again, like when I stated that if you need a specific thing to search, right, you can't put star. So if suppose you want your mail to get selected if the subject contains star, then you can put a star directly. You can, but for that also you need to put a thing over here. You need to put a star. So basically this email subject will have a star value assigned to it. See, same way star. Okay. So if you have any value, but you need some value, right, to search. How will you search without any specific value? So if you put a star, you can put it in a this format. So
what I'm saying is the in email subject, so somewhat server we have a 10 digit of means 10 words having in that email subject, and somewhere there is a server, whatever the server, whatever the word we are searching, so we can use that star server and that star. Right.
Yes. Yeah. Definitely. Star is there for wild character only. Okay. So you can do it in this way also. Or better, you can just you can save it in this format. So it will take star as wild character only. Or best way is just use a keyword over here, and at runtime you can specify star. Okay. So I have taken a variable with a value server assigned to it. So here, when the code enter in this loop, you can insert a if condition. So we have a thing called if variable. So when I explain you if, I will tell you. I'll just show you right now how to do it. If variable. So here you need to insert a variable. So right now, since I've entered in this loop, I need to check the email subject. So this is a system. And this is a system variable. Okay, check email subject. If this email subject includes, okay, here you need to provide include. We have all the operator over here, say equal to, not equal to, does not include, greater than, equal to, less than, equal to. But your criteria is you want to check whether some text is there or not. So here you need to include, select the include operator. So say if this email subject includes this text, so this is the fixing. Two things we can do, you can select fix or you can select variable. But if you select fix here, you can directly specify server. Let's put over here server. Okay, so either you can put the directly text from here, but I have taken a variable. Okay, so here, yeah, one more thing, better select a variable name. Suppose I select v email subject, so this will take the value from the v email subject. Save. Can edit it and put star over here only directly. It will take the wild character. Okay. So if the email subject, so here I am in this loop. So I using this particular condition, it will search. So if this email subject includes v email subject, so this is the variable email subject, the value which I've entered here is a star, server star. So if the email subject has any any particular like information which includes this particular value in the email subject, only it will enter in this if loop. Okay, so within a loop condition I am putting a if loop, so it will check over here. If this satisfies, then this particular whatever action which you want to perform, you can put it over here and execute this loop. Okay, I hope this clarifies your question.
Yes. And suppose this email having two attachment and I have to download a specific one, is it possible with that as well?
Yes, you can. Same way, you can get all the messages. And in get all the message, you need to provide your criteria. In get all messages, suppose you provide this. Let me just show you. Just make sure you get all these information correctly, then only it will execute. Provide your username and password correctly. AST. Provide this IMAP. If you're using POPs, you can select the POP selection. So message format. Here, what you can do is you need to download only specific attachment, right? Okay. Actually, in our project, what we do is we download all the attachment in a specific folder, and then using delete all the messages or delete the messages. What we actually do is we download all the attachments. See, here it says all the attachment. So we just download all the attachment because it cannot search for a specific attachment. So using this, we download all the attachment. Okay. We download all the attachment in a folder. Okay, so just put this get all messages and don't do anything over here. Just remove this. You can save the attachment directly over here. And what we do is we have since all the attachment will get downloaded in that specific folder, we can what we do is. There is a command called file send folder, and we insert a delete file. So suppose say like if you can provide a condition over there. So all the attachment like say delete files. So like you can put the condition over here. All the files say star result star. So all the files which contains this particular keyword will get deleted. Okay, that you can do. So at one go, basically, you know, all the attachments will get saved in this particular location. But if you want to keep the files and delete all the remaining files, so this way you can implement this. Okay, you need to delete a file, but for this you need to specify the keywords only. So apart from that, all the files should get deleted. This way you can implement.
If I don't want to get all other files get deleted because they are using for another bot. So can we search that specific file over there? We have a command over there, open file, and using a while character.
Yes, open. In the open file we have this open file. You can directly open the file, but this will just open the file. Okay, so this will just open the file with a specific character name over here. Same way, just insert the folder. Like insert a folder. It to provide your file name. Let's select this. And if you want, you can So this, what this will do is it will open all the file with a .csv as extension. Okay. Just click on save. So this will open the file. But you said that you need to save a specific file, right? Or you just need to work with a specific file with a CSV if you want to.
Okay, we can do that with that specific name of that file or any other file. Means we can use a while character as well, right?
Yes. This star is like you can use it as per your requirement. So just it's kind of what we can say. Suppose if you want to, So let's say anything if you want to search with a. Okay, so this is a, so basically when this will get executed, all the text, all a string which has a server keyword in it, it will get selected. Suppose say you select this star. Suppose you select s star dot doc. So all the file names starting with s will get selected only with the dot doc extension. Or suppose say ser star ser dot doc. So all the files starting with ser and ending with ser with some text characters in it with doc extension will get searched. So this is a wild character. Okay, so star indicates a wild character. You can use it as per your requirement. Okay, so this is how you can do it. You can combine one with one loop, if loop condition accordingly you can start searching. Okay, so how in our project we do is at one go we cannot delete save a specific attachment. So at one go what we do is we read all the attachment from all the email body, save it in a folder, then using file send folder command we do specific operation, delete the unwanted file directly. We search it with a specific criteria, like say if the file date or if file modified or file size and echo, and then we go ahead and perform a delete operation. At one go you just need to save all the attachment in one folder and then we perform a delete operation, so that we can do. That is a one constraint. So email automation doesn't work, so we cannot save a specific attachment at one point. At one go it will save all the attachment in one folder, and then when we get all the attachment we can perform file send folder command and delete remaining unwanted files in that folder. Okay, then we have a thing called delete all messages. Same way, delete all messages we can insert in this loop only, because at one go it will delete all the messages. Okay, so this is recommended only if you want to delete all the messages. Same way, just like get all messages, here you need to provide your email host address. Same way, IMAP POP3. If you want, you can select IMAP, else you can select POP3. Here, just provide this address. If you select the IMAP, here you can specify what type of a message. Suppose if you want to delete all the red messages, just select this and click on save. You see, this one line got created, there is no loop over here. So loop is always there when you get all the messages. So get all messages is kind of a select that you're firing. So it will select all the messages, all the red messages, and here you're deleting all the red messages. Suppose if you want to delete only the unread messages, you can select this and click on save. So that this will, you know, delete all the unread messages. You can put this in a loop condition. Let's say I put this over here. So say it will loop. It will loop here. What it will do is it will loop all the red. Let's say it will loop all the unread messages. So in those unread messages only, it will delete all the unread messages from this server. Okay. So this is how you can implement a delete unread messages. And if you want to delete a specific message, same way, you can select this delete message. Yeah, one thing. This one is correct. And this is correct. Sorry. In a loop, you always need to execute delete messages. Sorry, delete this messages will at one go delete all the messages. Okay, so keep this out of the loop only. Delete messages will just delete a single instance, right? So this you need to put only in the loop condition, because first automation anyway will check the loop, check the loop condition, because it, this delete messages doesn't has any, you know, settings over here. You can say in get all messages we have this hostname, username, password. Same in delete all messages, we have this hostname, username, password. But in delete message, single this is there. So this you can, this you need to implement only in the loop. Suppose if you put this statement over here, so this will not execute because it will check. So always put this in a loop condition in this loop. So it will loop and it will delete a single instance. So because it will iterate, let's say at first iteration it will iterate, and then when it come, it will come over here, it will delete that single instance. So same way it will go on looping. And if you want to delete all messages at one go, no need of using this loop. Okay, get all messages, just directly uses delete unread messages. As we are providing the information over here, hostname, username, password, delete all the messages. So it will delete all the messages at one go. Okay. Any doubts in this particular email messages? So same like what you have told in today's, like, you know, a use case which you have done, you can perform it at your end. If you work in your organization, you can start doing it. If you have the software with you, you can just start implementing it. Okay, put all the information correctly. And this is the email automation wherein you need to provide the incoming server. And if you want to send the email, do the email settings over here. Tools option, do the SMTP outgoing server detail configuration over here. And you can start using the incoming and outgoing server accordingly, okay, as per your requirement. Okay. This is pretty simple, but once you get familiar with all other commands, because see, at one instance we cannot, you know, like work with a single command. There are multiple commands in collaboration you need to work. See, here I have used a loop. In the loop I have put if loop. There are multiple commands. When you work with multiple commands, it really becomes a task easy to execute. Okay. So that is why once we say when we get hands-on with all these commands, you can easily start implementing. In collaboration with one command, you can start implementing and automate your task effectively.